Alright, this is a variation on a squat.
Done with dumbbells.
With a dumbbell squat, for most people, you'll probably want something to elevate underneath your heels. We've got a 10-pound plate on the floor here. It's a bumper plate. It's about an inch off the ground. Anything that'll get your feet up just a little bit will do. Well, it's a pair of smaller 10-pound plates that are smaller in diameter. Whatever gets you up just a little bit, small wedge, block, whatever will work. Stance is going to be right around shoulder width. If you go too wide with this type of dumbbell squat, your legs will get in your own way. So we'll grab the dumbbells, heels are going to come up. You want just the heel to be making contact with the weight plate. You don't want to back up so far that it gets underneath the arch of your foot, because then as soon as you apply pressure into your heel, your toes are now going to leave contact with the floor. So you're going to end up being relatively unstable. But if your heels are up, you can still keep your toes in contact with the floor too, but your heels are where you're placing all of your pressure. So your chest is up, your shoulders are back. I'm going to let my hips drop as straight down toward the back of my heels as I can. Because my heels are up, you're going to see more movement forward at my knees than you would if the heels were down. So my chest is up, I let my hips drop straight down. I want to try to keep going straight down until I reach the bottom. If you can get your hamstring and your calf to touch each other at the bottom, that's ideal. And then press yourself back up. So a couple of reps in a row, dropping straight down and pressing up. If you do this without a heel elevation, you'll find you won't be able to get quite as low. So typically your ankle flexibility and calf flexibility will play a role, as well as tightness in the hamstrings or lower back. Elevating the heels tends to alleviate a lot of that. There should not be very much hip movement on this. It's really easy to turn it into a deadlift. If you get a lot of hip movement, then your reps are going to start looking like this. And it's really not much different than the mechanics of a deadlift. And I want my torso to stay pretty upright, so I let myself go with the knees first. A little bit of hip movement is going to work, but it shouldn't be over-exaggerated. To keep straining off of the knee and the patella, you need the pressure to go through your heel. If you start feeling a lot of knee pain, there's a strong likelihood that you're putting more pressure through your toes than you are through your heel. If it's a flexibility issue, you may need to elevate your heels even higher than this 1-inch plate. You may have to stack more than one plate on top of itself. Use a higher surface. Because then you're going to get your heel up more and you're going to work around a lack of mobility through the ankle and through the calf. So that's the basics on the dumbbell squat.